We're continuing on number 10 of the intermediate algebra practice problems for midterm 1. At a store, Tim takes 30 minutes to stock a shelf alone, whereas Bob takes 40 minutes alone. How long will it take if they work together? Right. This is what's called a work problem. They're both working, and so they've got a rate they work at alone, but then when they're together, you know, they get done faster, of course. So what I like to do is first estimate it. So Tim takes 30 minutes. Now, if he worked with somebody that worked at the same pace, if there were two of them, it would take half as long. So that would take about 15 minutes. But then let's say the problem is he isn't working with somebody at the same pace. He's working with Bob. Bob takes 40 minutes. So if he worked with somebody at the same pace, that would be half the time. That would take 20 minutes. So the estimate is going to be somewhere between 15 and 20 minutes. A lot of people like to add 30 and 40, get 70, divided by 2, and say it's going to take 35 minutes. Well, that means it takes Tim longer working with somebody else than how long he does all by himself. So that doesn't make much sense. All right, so there's a strategy here. I like to use a chart. We're going to keep track of their rate and their time and their work done. So with work problems, we say the rate times their time equals the work done. And I've done several of these problems in previous videos. They're called work problems. Okay, so we need to keep track of the information. So we have Tim and Bob, and I like to write down how long it takes for them to work alone, and then their rate will be the reciprocal. So in other words, if it takes you 30 minutes to do something by yourself, your rate is 1/30th of the job done per minute. So alone, Tim takes 30 minutes, so his rate is 1/30th. Bob takes 40 minutes alone, so Bob's rate is 1/40th. He only gets a 40th done in a minute. That's why Tim gets done quicker. So in other words, if Tim worked for 15 minutes, he'd get half done. And that's the next thing we're going to do, is we're going to put how long they're each going to work, which will be their time. And the problem is, that's what we're trying to find. How long will it take if they work together? We don't know their time, so let's let that be our variable x. They're going to work the same amount of time. It didn't say that one started earlier. Their work done is the product of their rate and their time. So rate times time equals work. So Tim will get x over 30 done, and Bob will get x over 40 done. Alrighty. And what we want is that the whole job gets done. So if we take, was it Tim? Yes, Tim and Bob. Tim's work plus Bob's work equals one job. All right, what was Tim's work? X over 30. That's how much he got done. Bob, X over 40. And what did they get done? One complete job. All right, so here we are again. We have an equation and we have fractions. So you want to multiply both sides by the least common denominator. Well, what is it for 30 and 40? Do you know what it's going to be? Note, by the way, that 30 is 3 times 10, and 40 is 4 times 10. It's going to be 3 times 10 times 4. It's going to be 120. There's different ways of getting the least common multiple, but hopefully you're going to get the same answer. You could, of course, multiply it by 1,200. That's large. It's just that you'll have to do more reducing later on in the problem. All right, so I'm going to multiply both sides by 120. So I have 120 times x over 30 plus 120 times x over 40. And don't forget to multiply the right-hand side of the equation by 120 as well. So if I cancel, this gives me 4. This gives me 3. So I get 4x plus 3x equals 120. Right? Got to go on to a new page here. Seven x equals 120. Divide both sides by 7, and we've got our x. Now let's write 120 as a mixed number. So you just divide 7 into 120, and that goes 1, 7, and then that's gonna be 49. Your remainder's gonna be 1, so it's 17 and 1/17. Now, what did real x really stood for? It stood for their time, so minutes. So it looks like it's going to be 17 and 1/17 minutes. Well, let's see. How does that compare to our estimate? Our estimate, remember, was that it would take 15 to 20 minutes. So this seems like a reasonable answer. The last thing you want to do is write your answer. It asked how long it takes Tim and Bob working together. So you would say it takes Tim and Bob 17 and 1/7 minutes working together.